Hi, I'm Raymond Kakkar. I'm a film, television and OTT platform actor, and today I'm going to do something which I've never done before, introduce an author. So all of you know Bhavna is a film critic, a journalist, a columnist, but my association with Bhavna has been of a neighbor and a friend. She has written 16 books and Letters to Mother is her 17th book, and we are going to be chatting how this book was born, how did it reach the publisher, and most importantly, why should you be reading this book? So, Bhavna.
So, first and foremost, Raymond, thank you very much. I'm very privileged that I have an actor as a neighbor and as a friend, because when we are doing something like this, then you know, otherwise I have to handle it single-handedly, whereas I have you organizing the entire set and your beautiful daughter shooting us, Reshma Kakkar. Thank you, Reshma. Why this book was born. So what happened is, in 2008, I had done a translation of Lord Krishna. That was also a Gujarati translation into English. So one day a writer friend of mine called me up and he said, so what are you translating now? So I said, nothing. So he said, why? So I said, no, because it's very tough and I don't want to take on so much of responsibility. And he said, no, you have to translate. How about translating the Prime Minister's book? So I said, no, that's a huge responsibility and I am not equipped for it. I don't have the qualification, I don't have the expertise. But he was after me. And every week he would ring up and say, have you thought about it? Have you looked for his book? So finally, to just get him off my back, I said, I opened my bookshelf. I remember, cheers to my book, cheers, and to more interviews. So I said, I looked at the book called Sakshi. That was his Gujarati book. I had gone for the book release at Bhairas, and on the stage, Mr. Modi, at that time the Chief Minister of Gujarat in 2014, told the story of how this book was born. So in 1986, when he was not the Chief Minister, when he was definitely not the Prime Minister, when he was an ordinary RSS worker, he would write a diary. And in this diary, he would write his innermost feelings, his thoughts, his anxieties, his fears, his vulnerabilities, everything that he felt, he wrote it, and he addressed it to the mother goddess. So this journal, he had a habit, every 6 months, he would burn the pages of his diary, because he didn't want anybody to know what he's
doing. How did this survive?
So one day, while he was in the process of lighting the bonfire and burning it, a friend dropped by. The friend was led to the garden where Mr. Modi was at the job. And he said, what are you doing? And he stole the diary from him. And he said, you cannot do this. The fact that you have felt it, you thought about it, you wrote it, you value it. So now why are you disrespecting it? And then he didn't trust his friend with the diary. So when he went home, he carried the diary. Or kahin na kahin that baat publisher tak pahunch gayi, and the publisher said, I want to publish this book. So I read it, and it was very slow read for me, because you know, I am not educated in Gujarati. It was not a subject for me in school. It's my mother tongue. So my parents insisted I must know the mother tongue. So it was a slow read and it was a tough read. But when I read it, I thought about it for a week. Because there is too much churning, too much pain, too much suffering. And I said, oh my God, why is he going through so much of suffering? And if I do it, then I have to also go through it. So I thought, and then I said, okay. But I didn't tell anybody. Okay, I had decided, yes, not even that writer friend. I said, I'll just do it, because for all you know, I may not be able to do it, it may not be good. So if it turns out all right, then I'll think about the publisher. If it doesn't turn out all right, I'll leave it.
So I was reading and you've written that you've metaphased the book. Is that true?
Yeah, so in the daily parlance, what we call it is not paraphrase and metaphrase are little difficult words for the layman. So we say, is it a literal translation or is it a transcreation? So it is a transcreation. because it is impossible to do a literal translation. The language is different, the grammar is different, the rhythm is different, the beat is different. Often there are no exact words that you can find. Also, it never sounds nice if you do literal translation.
Because that's what I wanted to know. If it's a literal translation, then some emotion is definitely lost from Gujarati to English.
So the whole idea is to get the essence right, to get his feeling right. I was very, very clear that I don't want to lose his emotion.
Because
the book is rich because of the emotion.
Because of the emotion. When I was reading it, I said, there's so much pain, there's so much agony. And you know, we see our Prime Minister as someone we look upon, and you know, to see this side of him.
Yes.
Something which
you have nailed it. Yeah, you have nailed it. But that's because at that time he was neither the Prime Minister nor the Chief Minister, so he was ordinary like you and me, and that's wonderful.
Yeah.
That you know, you should. He writes that it is self-expression.
Yeah.
That he has a right to self-expression. So what if he's not a writer? And his self-expression may be correct prose, maybe not correct prose, maybe it is poetry, maybe it is not poetry, but they are letters. And he writes that, you know, whether anybody understands it or not, the mother goddess is understanding.
So tell me one thing, you were writing a book on the Prime Minister, right? While writing, how was it? Were you writing, did you think of him as a writer or, I mean, the Prime Minister, I mean, the most powerful man?
Everybody asks me this, and the thing is, when I'm writing or when I'm translating, for me he's just an author and I'm the translator. So I am flowing with the flow. But what would happen is, in the evening I would shut the book and I would put on the television, and Mr. Modi would go from left to right and right to left on different channels, and I'll say, is this the guy? I'm translating. What is happening, you know, it is a dichotomy to handle, and then I will say, he can say what he wants on the TV, he can do what he wants with the country, I am concentrating on this book.
Didn't it interfere with
you know, because Raymond, when I would be doing a book on Mr. Bachchan, so what would happen
not
is,
one, but I think
three.
Four.
So what would happen is, his films are releasing in between, there are events where I am bumping into him, and the book is going on, so I would not want to meet him. So I would see him, I would review his film, but I would prefer if we will not get into a longer conversation. Because first I want to finish the book.
Yeah.
The Prime Minister, I'm not meeting him, so it's fine.
But did you get to meet him during the...
I just had one meeting with him, which was at the Rajmahal in Mumbai when he was passing by.
Okay.
Where I just needed to kind of put it in his head that I was thinking of this and this.
So did you get a feedback from as he read it? Did you get a feedback?
No, I think he's on too important a position to give me a personal feedback. But
I'm sure, I mean, the way you've written it, it just touches the heart. So if he,
there has been a positive vibration from the PMO, and as a journalist, I know that from anybody, particularly actors and celebrities, no feedback is always positive feedback. It's when you get a call, alarming one, ke ye kyun kar diya, that is the time to start.
So also, there's a lot of pain when you read. What was your thought process while writing? I mean, did you go through, like, I don't know, I mean, I'm not a writer, so I, when I'm doing a scene where there's a lot of pain in that particular scene, where I have to enact, so I have to actually feel, like, I remember I was doing this scene where my child is dead in the show, and I just got the news, and just the thought, you know, I had to imagine myself, and I remember I didn't use any costume, I was crying, and cut ho gaya, main phir bhi ro rahi thi, and the director said, you know, it's over, and I had to tell them that give me half a second. I need to, you know,
absorb
and just, so the thought of, you know, imagining. So with you, you know, so much of pain, did you go through any kind of...
I did. Because, you know, he's charming. And his pain is also to an extent of meditation. You know, he almost looks like in a bliss at times. It's different for a writer from an actress, because the writer is projecting it physically, whereas the writer has to absorb it emotionally and internally, and it's only words that are coming out. So there were times when I was feeling very exhausted and drained, and I was saying, why is he suffering so much? And why is he observing so much? Why is he absorbing so much? Then I was even thinking that, is he overthinking? Is he overanalyzing? But then I was also saying, that's his personality and I should let him be. So I was also feeling maybe he should have somebody to talk to, because if he's going through this kind of a phase, who is he sharing with? And because I don't understand the politics of I did research, but there was nothing available. Also, his suffering is not only private, it is also on a social level. He's wanting to change the nation, he's wanting to change society, he's wanting to bring more welfare to humanity, he is wanting an ideal utopian world. So, you know, he's, as you saw, that he's also so deeply connected to nature. He talks about the skyline, he talks about the colors changing, he talks about trees, the withering leaves, he talks about river, ocean, and he analyzes and compares it with stream. Then why is the stream like this? Why is the river like this? So I'm thinking, so much is he thinking. His imagination is very, very vivid.
So also the Gujarati book Sakshi Bhav literally means, you know, a person who is at a very high level of self-awareness. Is that
yes.
The right meaning of another word?
Yes.
So what was your take, you know, when you were reading it? Was what was your take?
I do feel that he is at a very meditative phase. And it's not possible to feel so much unless you are at a stage of evolvement, self-awareness, or even awareness for the universe, planet. I felt, like I said, he's connected to nature. I also felt that he is beyond himself. It's not about self.
Yeah.
It is about serving others. And in fact, I feel now that the foundation, जैसे कहते हैं कि इमारत बुलंद इसलिए है क्योंकि वो सारी qualities you can see in that.
So
there is strength, there is silence, there is positivity, there is optimism, there is creativity, there is suffering that is used constructively. Productively.
So, is there a favorite poem that you have and you could read for us?
Not a poem, a letter.
Okay.
I have not got my specs, but I will try. Because in the book there are certain highlighted pages. This. At times, life appears a tomb of dreams, ushering speed and thoughts, and at times a ruin of dreams soaked in tears. Then he's talking about his conversation with the goddess, where he complains to her and says, punish this body if you have to, break it into pieces, I will not cringe. But tell me, mother, is it fair to bruise me thus? So, you know, he talks about bruise, he talks about scathing, he talks about burning, he talks about the sun scathing him, the scars. This is about optimism. I want to light lamps in every feeble, dreamless eye. I want to ignite speed into all drained, standstill feet. I want to shake up the silent ocean, row oars of passion into the quietly flowing waves. So we will not read more, because what is important is that people buy the book. So Raymond, whatever you read, what is your takeaway?
So I felt that, you know, he has gone through
so much.
Has gone through so much, and probably why? And I could, you know, probably think that a person who has gone through so much is the reason why he is the person today. And like I always look upon him as a great orator, you know. And when he's when he comes on TV, I'm just like glued to it. And when you read this, there are two different personalities. But today, what he is because maybe because of this, you know. When you given a raat ki ka din aata hai, so you know this is his night, and what we are seeing him today is the day. He's gone through that emotion and pain, and that's why he's such a strong and powerful person.
So the whole idea is to present the Prime Minister as a human being, and obviously that has reached you.
It just touches the heart.
So what would you like to say to the readers, why they must buy this book? I'm going to hold it, both of us are going to hold it and say.
So I think, you know, to know what makes a great orator, a great leader, this is something which touched my heart definitely. And I'm sure when you read it, you will realize that you know, when you're going through pain, when you're going through agony, it is not to give up, but to change that pain into something positive. And what our Prime Minister has done exactly that. And this is what I could take from the book, that, you know, he changed his pain into the person he is today.
Fantastic. I don't think I want to add anything more to that, because that was a super sum up. And now we will say cheers again.
Yes. Cheers to
each other and to the book.